Hello designers and welcome back to another Affinity Designer tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to rotate multiple nodes using the transform mode and transform origin. Check out what this thing can do. It can really help speed up your workflow and help you get more creative. Also, for those of you who are not subscribed to my channel, go ahead and click subscribe. It really pushes me to create more videos, as well as the super thanks down there that's just been implemented not long ago. So let's get on with the video. And we are in Affinity Designer, and the first thing I want to show you is how to select and rotate multiple nodes at once. And I'll give you an example, a scenario of where you might want to use this. And as the video progresses, you'll learn more and more about this, but I'll start off from the basics, okay? In front of you are a couple of keyholes. This is our keyhole here. And what I want to do is I want to cut this keyhole out of this back plate here. Now, this back plate does have a 3D effect applied to it. If you're trying it at home, don't worry, you don't have to do this as well, but it kind of helps to show off what I'm doing a bit more, I guess. So I'm going to click close on that. So I'm going to cut this shape out of the backplate. So first one is selected. I'll keep my finger on shift and select the backplate. You can see they're both selected in the layers panel. So now go up to Boolean operations, which are up here, and you want to click on the subtract. So I've clicked it. You can see we can now see through that shape. It's been cut out. At some point in the past, maybe, or if you're new to this program, you might be thinking, oh no, I've made a mistake. It's a bit skew if it's not straight. How do I fix it? You'd probably think, yeah, I can press Command Z to go back a step and then rectify your mistake. But in this scenario, we're not going to do that. We're going to keep it like this. And from this point, we're going to hit the node tool, which is A up here. So we can see the nodes. So you can see I can move it around. It's pretty cool that the 3D effect is still there, I think. But I want to select all of these nodes and rotate it. So you can select all of them like that. Just drag it over to select them all. And you can move the whole shape around like this, but it's not evident how you would rotate this shape to get it to how you want. Well, if you want to do that, head on up here. It says transform. And right next to it, it says transform mode. If you click on that one, you can see there's a box around the shape now. So now I can rotate the shape to wherever I like, and it's done. Great, I'm happy with that. I can move on. That's one way. Here's a better way of doing it for those of you who don't know about creating compound shapes or compound layers. So I'm just going to delete this example here and drag this new one into the middle. So in this example, I have not added these two parts together, so it looks like a key shape, just because it's going to help you understand compounds a little bit better. I'm going to select the circle, I'm going to select the triangle, and I'm going to select the backplate. I've done all that. Now we're going to create a compound. So go up to layer. So layer creates compound. Click on that. Another way of doing it, I'm not going to click that one. Another way of doing it is to head on up to subtract up here in the Boolean operations, keep your finger on option and click subtract. You see, there's two ways of doing it. So if we look in the layers panel here, you can see we have a group. It's called compound. If I click on the drop down arrow, you can see inside are all our shapes, the backplate, circle, the triangle. So we can select them individually and move them towards each other to create our key shape. So you see, this way gives you a lot more flexibility if you're going to make mistakes or you want to make changes. And you can also, I have a whole video on this, by the way, so check out my other YouTube videos. But you can also head on over here in the layers panel and you can click on the options here. And instead of having subtract, I can click add or intersect and Zora, I think it is. Anyway, I'm going to keep it on subtract. So there it is, our keyhole done a lot better. So in this example, I'm going to be showing you again where I might use the transform mode to rotate multiple nodes, but also how to scale as well. So here's an example. I've got some hair. It's all over the place. And I want to get these hair strands to be sticking more upright. So I click on the node tool. Instead of clicking and dragging a square like this, this time I'm going to be clicking option and clicking and dragging so I can draw around the particular ones I want. Okay, now they're selected. Go up to transform mode, click on that, and you can start rotating to the angle that looks best. So I'll just zoom out a little bit, see what looks good. Maybe something like that. And obviously you can tell that it's kind of messed up this strand a little bit, and you can just go tidy that up afterwards. So I'll just click on this one here and just tidy it up a bit. So that's one way I might do it. That actually looks worse, doesn't it? Okay, so moving on to these strands here, I'm going to select this lot. So I'm going to click Option and draw around the nodes I want. And so instead of rotating, this time we're just going to be clicking from the side here, holding down Command, and you can see it kind of zooms in on it. I hold Command and Shift to keep it straight like this. So for different areas that are like maybe it's a little bit small, you can make it a lot bigger. You can drag it down to flatten it a little bit. So it could be really handy in scenarios like this where there's plenty of handles to be played around with that would otherwise take a very long time. Okay, moving on. So this time I want to show you how to use the transform origin as well as the transform mode to rotate all of those nodes. So let's get in and do it. Okay, so we have a hand here, and what I want to do with the hand is I want it to wave kind of from the wrist. Imagine keeping your arm totally still and your hand waving from left to right. I want that to happen. So let's go ahead and do it. Click on the node tool, click option and select all of these. And I'll just select the nodes that are above the wrist there. If I head on up to transform, click on that. And if I click left and right, like to rotate it, you can see it's rotating from the center. I'll zoom in on post-production so you can see where the center is. So I don't want the center to be there anymore. So with enable transform origin on, you can see this little crosshair here. I can move that crosshair, which is the center, that's where it's rotating from. I can click and move that down here near the wrist. So now when I click and rotate this square here, it'll be rotating from down there near the wrist, and I'll zoom in so you can see it in post-production. So now there's a more of a natural kind of movement to the wave. So using that is super handy sometimes. So that's one example. I'm going to show you a snake talking now. Okay, here is the snake, and I got him from the stock tab here. See just this one here? I just clicked and dragged that off onto our canvas. So I'm going to make him talk by using all of the things I've just shown you. Zooming in, hit the node tool, select kind of the jaw there, click on transform. Make sure enable transform origin is clicked as well. And we can see that the origin is there. If we rotated it from here, it doesn't work, does it? So I will click and drag that over there where the kind of jaw is. And now, there we go, he's talking now. He's nattering. Cool, so if you were gonna make maybe an animation, you can kind of change each frame. So moving on. This is a shape I created using the star tool and transform mode to rotate those nodes. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how I created that. Head on over to the star tool right here and click and drag from the center, holding down shift and command to get a nice big star. The next thing we're going to do is choose the amount of points. There's 5. So we're going to drag it up until there's loads of them. And then if you grab these handles here and bring it out a little bit, it makes that effect look a lot cooler. Now we have to convert it to curves so that we can see the nodes. Okay, there are all the nodes. We're going to select all of the center nodes here. So hold down Option, click and drag around till they're all selected. Head on up to transform like we have been doing throughout this tutorial. And then you can drag and rotate and you see what happens now. It just naturally happens. It's really cool. And if you wanted to add different colors in there, then you just press G on the keyboard. That's your fill tool. I'll do it over here so you can see which one I'm clicking on. And you just click out and drag. And we don't want a linear one because right now it's linear mode. It's going from one side to the other. We're going to go up to type and change it to elliptical. And we're going to place that in the center. Change the color of the center. And then on the outside, we'll make it a different color again, like that. And you can get really creative with this. You can press Command J to duplicate that. Just move it across a little bit so there's another one behind. Change the color slightly. Very trippy. I'll just quickly show you another example. So I've got the star tool again. Drag it in a little bit. I'll change the amount of points. So there's quite a few of them. I'll make it a bit rounded at the top here. And let's see what else we can do. That's it. I'll make that a little bit skinnier. Drag it out. Okay, so from this point, convert to curves, click A, the node tool, select all of the inner ones, inner nodes, and we go up to transform and turn it around a little bit. And just leaving it at that, it looks pretty cool. And here's another shape created using the cog tool, which is down here. And for this one, again, convert to curves. You can select the outside nodes this time. So what I'd do, I'd go around like this, and then I'd go in and around here, avoiding all the inner nodes. So all the outside ones are selected. Hit transform, and you can just move the outside one. So you kind of got some weird cog sun looking thing here. Not sure what it is. And another example, I've got these three peaks. Just hit transform up there, and I can just move it around like that. If I go all the way around, there's a pentagram. So the last example is just all about experimentation, really. I've got six bars here, and we're going to use the transform mode to see what we can come up with. So select all of them. Select the top nodes, transform, and then click, and you can drag it around like this. That's a cool shape there, isn't it? I mean, with this, you could probably duplicate it and twist it around. I'm not sure what this is, but it looks cool. And there we go, we've got a shape. Or you can keep going around. Let's see if the transform is still there. It is, cool. Keep going around until you reach something like that. Looks like a kind of 80s backdrop, this one, doesn't it? Or something you'd see in a fairground. And that's it for today's video. I hope I've helped you somewhat, and maybe you've learned a little bit more about the program, and maybe I've helped you to just explore more, press buttons and not worry about the consequences, because that's what it's all about, isn't it? Trial and error. So if you like this video, go ahead and click like, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you on the next video. So until then, ciao.